Hi there, Julie here. Welcome back. Today I'm gonna have a little look at Nik Collection 8. Now I did a preview just a couple of days ago, but today I thought I'm gonna explain what Nik Collection is for those of you who don't know what on earth all the fuss is about. Nik Collection is a suite of really powerful photo editing plugins you can use in Photoshop or Lightroom, or you can use them as standalone apps as well. They're built for creative control, total professional precision, and some really cool artistic enhancements. So, what is the Nik Collection? Let's go have a look. So this is a quick look inside Nik 8 Viveza. Viveza is all about light adjustments. Make precise exposure, contrast, color changes, all using intuitive control points. There's no selections or masks needed, although you can put masks on in Photoshop and bring those into, but I don't want to overcomplicate things. So you've got different presets and things that you can apply with one touch over here on the left, and then you can go in and you can play around with all your global adjustments. You can also do local adjustments using what they call control points, and there's different control points, so you can have an elliptical control point, and you can control everything from in there, and that only affects the area in there. You can also have control lines, so if you want to have a line where you only want it to fit, and you can move it, or you can jump between them. So you can play around with different control points. If you decide you don't want that, you can take it off. Pop it back on again. So lots you can do in Viveza. Viveza, think of it as lighting adjustments. Okay, from Viveza, I can then jump over, if I click up here, go to Nik Color Effects. Now you can save it from there, you can apply those adjustments, go back into Lightroom. I have no idea why it's flipping my images around upside down, but this is color effects. This is your go-to for color and tonal adjustments. Viveza was light adjustments, this is color and tone adjustments. There is over 50 filters to stylize, correct, and creatively grade your images. I'm talking color grade, obviously. So you can add infrared film effects, you can add glamour glows. There's so much you can do. And each one of these, when you click the little arrow, it has different strengths of that preset. So there's a subtle glow, if you want a stronger glow, if you want a really strong glow, you can have a cool glow, you can have a warm glow. So there's lots of different looks you can put in here. So if you're after colors and you want to change and go to by color filters, so for instance, if you want to go to brown, cool colors, things like that, you've got all your different color effects. If you want contrast, jump over to contrast. You've got things like bleach bypass that you can use. So you've got normal, high contrast, things like that. You have got clear view. You have got the detail extractor, which is another one that's really cool. Pro contrast is another one that is fabulous. Lots in here. If you just want basic adjustments, you've got clear view, color ranges, contrast, things like that. You can import others, you can create your own custom presets, and of course all your personal favorites you can go through and you can put in there. It'll bring up your last edits, your history, etc. Of course, once you have gone in and put a preset on it, let's go into subtle red preset or cool blue. Cool blue looks cool. So on the right hand side, then you can come in and you can play around. So I'm in colorize, but if I drop this down, I've got different colors that I can play with in here. I have the strength of the color. I can pick a particular color if I want to go to it. Shadows, highlights, and of course your local adjustments are all there. So color effects, think of this as color and tonal enhancements. The next one is one of my favorites. This is analog effects. And if you love playing with vintage camera looks, light leaks, retro film grain, just about anything you can think of, double exposures, wet plate, anything like that, analog effects is so much fun. So you've got double effects, you've got monochrome look, you've got photo plate looks. So there's so many different looks that you can play with. And when you click on one of the filters over here, then you can come over here and you've got your basic adjustments, your brightness, contrast, detail extractor, local adjustments there too if you want local as well as global. Then you can play with different bokeh, and you've got different shape of bokeh, the strength, the blur, dirt and scratches. And if you click on the drop downs, it just goes on. So there's different types of dirt and scratches. So many, and you can apply them with local adjustments to certain areas. You've got photo plates, so you've got streaked, corroded, concrete looks, again, local adjustments. You've got lens vignettes that you can play with. You've got film types, so you've got warm, cool, subtle, you've got black and white, loads, and each of these different filters has different effects that you can put to it. There is motion, so if you want double exposures, you want motion, and you can move your motion around, you can play with the strengths of it, you can protect the center. So if you want just a certain area, and you can change the size of this, you can fix the zoom strength, you can rotate the zoom. So much that you can do with it. Loads of fun. You've got classic cameras. You've got multi-lens looks. So if you want to do multi-lens splits on your images, you can do that. You've got vintage. You've got toy cameras. If I go to double exposure, give it a second to just click over. You can bring in your base image, but you can also bring in another secondary image as well. So you can go through and you can click on another image to bring in, and then you can move that around and play with that. There's just so much you can have in here. It's great. Light leaks. There's a huge amount of light leaks, whether you want crisp, dynamic. You can put frames in too. So if you want a frame on your edge, you can do all of that. So much stuff that you can play in analog effects. Just be warned, you can lose an awful amount of time, but have fun playing with this one. This is silver effects. This probably has to be, I think, everybody's favorite plugin. If you love black and white, whether it's vintage, modern, street, landscapes, silver effects is amazing. I think it's probably the industry leading black and white conversion program out there, with film emulations, total control over everything from tonal ranges to contrast, global, as well as local adjustments. You can do everything. You can go into different film types. You can play around with your histogram. You can play around with luminosity masking. You can even though it's black and white, you can still play with your color channels. So film sensitive, so yellows and things like that, you can bring in, you can play with that. There's levels and curves, you can add grain, you can do lots. Then you've got all your presets over here. You've still got your original color image that you can look at. There's lots of filters, so if you want to add film grain, you've got different types of film grain that you can add. If you want to go to color filters, you want to go to vignettes, burned edges, borders. So if you want to put frames on your image, you can. And everything has a drop down. So if you want to explore different features, you can. You want to go into color grading and things like that. So let's just go over to classic. I'm going to go into color filters. You can play with your different filters. You can adjust the color, the tone, the strength. You can go into film types. So there's different film types that you can put in. And when I say film types, so you've got like, you know, Kodak or Ilford or Agfa. There's a lot. Foma Pan. There's Ilford Delta. Lots of different things that you can play with in there, and they're all totally customizable. You want grain, you don't want grain, you can play with that. So you've got grain softness and grain per pixel. So there's lots that you can play with in here. It is absolutely fantastic. And of course you can, these are all non-destructive too. I didn't even mention that. All of this is completely non-destructive. It does not affect your original file, whether you come in from Lightroom or whether you come in from Photoshop. So this is a truly amazing plugin if you love your black and white images. So they're the main ones that everybody seems to love in Nik, but there's also HDR effects, so that allows you to merge bracketed images and create your own HDR effects. There is also Dfine, which is, think of it as noise reduction, and you can also do like profile detection and things like that for your camera. Great for high ISO or low light shots, things like that. So that's Dfine. So you've got HDR merge, you've got Dfine, then there's a sharpener. So there's an output sharpener that you can use on your final images, but there is also the Sharpener Pro for image correction. So this is the pre-sharpener. So I've got this image here, which is a little bit grainy, so I can switch it to high ISO. I've also missed the focus a little bit. So by using the adaptive sharpening, I can bring it out a little bit and I can decide on how much of the balance that I want between having that real crunchy look and softening it off a little bit as well. You can also go in and you can play around with your selective sharpening. You've got color ranges and things like that you can play with. You can click in here and you can select what color ranges, and you can modify them as well and bring them down. So you've got oranges, and once you've done that, you can then go from there again, as I said, into any of the other programs. So that's it for Nik Collection. Each plugin launches from Lightroom or Photoshop. You make your edits, then save it, and it returns the image back to your original workflow. It's seamless, it's fast, it's non-destructive. If you're into fine art, still life, creative portraits, street photography, landscape, and you want more control over your light, your tone, your detail, then Nik Collection delivers advanced tools without the overwhelming complexity. It's a paid suite by DxO, but there is a free trial. You get lifetime use and regular updates, and there's no subscription required. Yes, it can be a little bit on the pricey side, but when you consider you're actually getting not one program, you're getting a whole suite of programs for that one price, it's actually not bad. And what you can do with it is totally amazing. Grab your free trial. I'll put the link down below and test it out for yourself, and let me know in the comments what you think of Nik Collection. If you have been using 6 or 7, you can jump over to DxO and you can just grab the upgrade from Nik 6 or 7 to Nik Collection 8, and you will save quite a bit of money. So that's it from me. If you really enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and I will see you next time on YouTube. Bye!